All right, time for a look at what's making music headlines this week. Lori Logan joining us in studio. And now this is a story that started popping up yesterday online, and it has just kind of spread like wildfire, and that's Marilyn Manson getting into a fight at Denny's in Lethbridge, Alberta.
Yeah, it's actually kind of funny. I hate to say it, but
when I saw the headline, I had to click on it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So apparently he was at a Denny's, you know, it was about 3 a.m. and got into an altercation. Now there's two sides to every story, of course. One of them being that he was cussing at a table nearby and somebody punched him in the face. The other one, it was that it was completely unprovoked. And I tend to believe that story a little bit more, but his makeup artist was actually involved in the scuffle as well, so.
So this is coming out from a statement from his people, right?
Yes.
And so he is saying that he was just sitting there basically minding his own business?
Yeah, well, not necessarily minding his own business, but he was signing autographs for a couple of girls, and maybe somebody got a little jealous, or they didn't like that too much, or maybe they were just angry because they were eating at Denny's at 3 a.m. I don't know.
All right, the other thing that had me, you know, wondering was, what was he doing at Denny's at 3 a.m. in Lethbridge?
Well, touring through the country, and desperate times call for desperate measures. You get hungry, and a lot of these musicians will be stopping at any place that they can to grab a bite.
So he had just wrapped up a show in Lethbridge that night, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
So there is apparently charges that are going to be, they are going to press charges. They haven't yet, but they're saying that they're going to.
Okay, that's a story that won't be leaving the headlines anytime soon, so we'll see what happens with that one. Now, also, the Peak Performance Project is taking, I guess, applications, you would say, right now?
Yes, and this music competition is huge. It's the biggest one in Canada, if not North America. First prize is $102,000, second is $75,000, and third is $50,000. So life-changing amounts for some of these bands, and right now the application process is open.
So what happens then for the winners?
It's a talent competition basically for bands and musicians in Alberta and in BC, of course. But basically, you enter the competition and 12 different bands will be chosen. They go through a boot camp, basically. They get music training and they learn about the business of music, and of course they win massive amounts of money too.
So. All right, any big names that we may have known of that have done this before?
Yeah, Said the Whale was one that did very well a couple of years ago. They won a Juno Sense, Current Swell, Vince Vaccaro, Kyprios, the Boom Booms, Dear Rouge. They just did a cross-country tour with the Arkells. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. We'll have to see who wins that. So when does that wrap up then?
April 24th is the deadline to apply. Yes.
And Whistler also has a lot of music artists flocking there for their festival.
Yeah, the Whistler Ski and Snowboard Festival, that is kicking off on Friday. And it's just a great way to get up on the mountain, support Whistler. It hasn't been the best season for them.
Yeah.
And there is 10 days of free shows as well. So that's
free.
Kicking off.
Everyone loves free.
Yeah, absolutely. So Swollen Members are going to be playing, Humans. We've got Mastercraft, which is going to be closing out the festival on the 19th. And that was started by one of the guys from Death From Above, 1979. So that's actually going to be a really huge show, and it's free.
And this is a pretty long-running festival there.
Yeah. It's 10 days, and it's been bigger in the past. It's a little bit scaled back, but sometimes that's nice. You're not dealing with a lot of the lineups, and you know, again, it's free, so you can't really go wrong.
Yeah, exactly. No complaints.
Yeah.
All right. Now, here's someone who hasn't really been in the spotlight that much, and now we're kind of finding out why, and that's Avril Lavigne.
Yeah, she sent out a cryptic tweet a couple of months ago saying she was dealing with health issues, and she asked her fans to pray for her, which... you know, when your friend says on Facebook, hey, I'm going to the hospital and it's a Monday night and that's all they say, it really, you know, causes some concern, and that's all she said for months.
Okay.
So finally now it's come out that she has had Lyme disease and she was bedridden for about 5 months.
Yeah, you know, it's scary because actually just a few weeks ago we had a warning that went out by Interior Health. You know, with the temperature this spring and the mild winter, that they were putting out a warning for people heading out into the backcountry to wear long clothing and, you know, long sleeve shirts and stuff because of the danger for getting a tick bite. And obviously if you get a tick bite, you can get Lyme disease, and that's how we heard that she actually got it, from a tick bite.
Yeah, in bed for 5 months. She said her health is at about 80% now. She is back at work though. She's going to be releasing a new single on April 16th. It's called Fly, which is a little ironic, but
Little, yeah.
But it's really not actually about that sort of connotation. It's about empowerment, and it's for the special World Olympics that's happening in LA in July and August. And all the proceeds from the song are also going towards the cause as well.
All right. Well, let's hope that she gets better and is healthy.
Yes.
All right. Lori, thanks so much
for
joining us.